All right, Barry, thank you very much. Well, we've got a couple of more fights coming up, and one of them is for the vacant WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World. And in this particular fight, you know, Ricardo El Matador Mayorga is really a walking soundbite. He is so confident of himself. He says he'll have the tattoo taken off his neck if he doesn't win. And now we'll soon find out.
I'm ready to do my job, get in the ring, and destroy like I know.
It's a bird, it's a plane, no, that's a brick, boy. I got a lick, grab them things, let's get rich, boy. Pit bull chillin', rich boy chillin'. What more can I say? Let's get millions in the park.
Eso significa...
This flag represents my country, Nicaragua. It's my passion, my heart.
Y yo soy una de las que estoy explotando para que mi país luzca mejor.
What I like most about boxing is when people come to see me and watch me fight. And I like having them hate me like I'm the bad guy. I like being the bad guy.
The bars are stealing, the bars killing. Up in the hood, the bars killing. I'm cold with the sweaters on like little Charlie Brown.
Ricardo Mayorga, yo soy el matador, ese nombre que yo meto aquí del matador.
Pizzarillo is a nobody. I don't even have to punch him hard.
Michele Pizzarillo.
They can call me crazy, but I'm not playing. Come and see me knock out Pizzarillo and become champion again. Get that belt in 2 rounds. I'm the same matador that everyone knows.
Now when them boys get the popping.
So we come now to the WBC Super Welterweight Championship. Ricardo Mayorga, from whom you just heard, against Michele Pizzarillo. And Mayorga, actually, you heard him say 2 rounds. He changed that yesterday when we talked to him. He said, I'm going to knock him out in 16 seconds. So we'll see.
No, he said 14 to 16. He gave himself a little room.
That's right, a couple of seconds room. And that includes the count, he said. So we'll see what he's got. We'll see what happens if, in fact, he doesn't manage to get Pizzarillo out of there in 16 seconds or less. Here is Michele Pizzarillo, and this is a guy that I don't think is going to take a backward step, and he's got a lot of experience.
Well, the experience is there, 47 fights. His record 44-2, and there's been one no contest. He's a former world champion. He defeated Corey Spinks, although by a very controversial decision in Italy, and then lost the title back to Spinks in their second fight. He's more of a boxer. And there's no doubt that he will attempt to use more of the Corey Spinks style than the Tito Trinidad style when it comes to fighting Mayorga. Corey Spinks beat Mayorga with boxing, and Tito Trinidad, of course, beat him with punching power. But Pizzarillo is a boxer.
Yeah, and the one thing, too, is I really don't believe that Mayorga will be able to get into Pizzarillo's head like he might be some others.
Tonight's telecast is brought to you by the best in boxing, Don King Productions on DKTV.
So Pizzarillo will now have to await the arrival of Ricardo Mayorga. Made a long talk with Mayorga yesterday, and fact of the matter is, I think he's a very bright guy, and I think he's kind of putting the whole world on. I think he knows exactly what he's doing. All of that said, he's lost two of his last three fights. So he's got to win this fight. I think probably win it in person.
And there also was controversy over him getting the title fight. And so what has happened is that the winner of this fight tonight is going to be mandated to fight the winner of Fernando Vargas against Javier Castillejo next week. But you're right, Bear. I mean, this is he's a smart guy. He's street smart, but he's very quick. He's very funny, Mayorga, in his own way. And he put on a real comedy routine for us yesterday, basically. But this is a guy who I've never seen anybody quite like Ricardo Mayorga, one who never has any regard for his opponent, any respect, really, for his opponent. I wonder if that's an act, but I just don't get the feeling that it is, because that just seems to be how he feels about people.
And you see him walk around, he's the same way all the time. It's not like you're going to catch him in a quiet moment where he's meditating. He's tough all the time and relaxed.
Well, at least he's not smoking yet.
Not yet.
No smoking in this building.
Take a look at the numbers, and let's see once more how these two match up with each other. Pichirito is 3 years older than Mayorga, so again, a couple of guys who have been around the track. Other than that, the numbers are very comparable. Pichirito is an inch taller than Ricardo Mayorga. Mayorga's just going to go after him. There's no question about it. And I think the first 30 seconds of the first round should be explosive, and then we'll see what happens.
Well, there's one other thing. I'm sure he will go after him, but he now has a new trainer, Yoel Judah. Not a new trainer, but he has come in to add to the training. And, of course, Yoel Judah, the father of Zab Judah, was come in to try to add a few defensive nuances, if possible, and a little more subtlety to the attack of Mayorga, if possible.
You see the rules, they are as they have been all night long. A lot of support from the Nicaraguan fans here at the United Center in Chicago.
It's great, the international flavor here tonight. You know, you got all these flags from the different countries, and all the fighters seem to have their own rooting sections. It makes it a lot of fun.
Pichirito will have people rooting for him too. There are a lot of people made the trip from Italy, and of course a very big Italian population here in Chicago as well. With that, we go to Jimmy Lennon Jr. in the introduction of the fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to the United Center here in Chicago, Illinois. At this time, we present another one of our world title attractions brought to you by Don King Productions in association with the United Center. This bout coming away is sanctioned by the World Boxing Council, the President Jose Suleiman, Supervisor Bismarck Morales, along with the Illinois Department of Financial and Professional Regulation. Our three judges scoring the bout from ringside. From Bangkok, Thailand, Anek Hong Tong Kam. From Chicago, Illinois, John McCarthy. And from Dallas, Texas, Oren Schellenberger. And introducing our third man in the ring, the referee in charge of this bout, Gerald Scott. Thank you. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue trunks with white trim, hailing from Bari, Italy. He weighed in at the super welterweight limit of 154 pounds. His record, 44 wins, 2 losses, with 27 wins coming by way of knockout. Currently ranked the WBC number 3 super welterweight contender. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the former IBF welterweight champion of the world, known as the gentleman, introducing Michele Pichirillo. And his opponent across the ring on my left, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks with red trim, hailing from Managua, Nicaragua. He weighed in the same as his opponent, 154 pounds. His record stands at 26 wins, 5 losses, 1 draw, 1 no contest, with 22 wins coming by way of knockout. He is currently ranked the WBC number 2 contender. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the former WBC and WBA welterweight champion of the world, introducing Ricardo El Matador Mayorga. Once again, our referee in charge is Gerald Scott, now to give instructions. 12 rounds of world championship boxing scheduled.
Let's go. Okay, you had your instructions in the dressing room. I want a good, clean, professional fight. Protect yourself at all times. Obey my commands. Touch gloves. Good luck.
So now we'll see about the 16 seconds.
Mayorga says, frankly, I've seen tapes of him. I don't think much of him.
Yeah, exactly. He was very entertaining when we talked to him. And again, you have an idea that it's all figured out. He gets it.
But this is his first fight since the Tito Trinidad, for him, disaster. A fight that he actually announced his retirement afterward.
He did try to come with the right hand. Catches Picciarillo with the left hand.
Picciarillo is expecting this. He knows, said, I know he's going to come out strong for me in the first couple of rounds. He expects about three rounds of this.
Picciarillo on his bike, and not a bad idea.
Mayorga had a devil of a time hitting Corey Spinks solidly over their 12 rounds.
And Spinks fought him very much like Picciarillo is doing right now. He fought him side to side.
The good thing about Mayorga, he knows what he can do over the long period, the long haul. He's throwing hard shots. He understands his pace. Maybe he doesn't know enough about Picciarillo, though.
By the way, we will probably not see Ricardo stick his chin out tonight and ask Picciarillo to hit him the way that he did against Vernon Forrest in their second fight and the way that he did against Tito Trinidad. He said his father asked him to promise that he would not stick his chin out and let his opponent hit him tonight the way that Trinidad did in that last fight.
And he said, your father asks you, you got to do it.
That's wonderful.
His mom, incidentally, is good. She was in his entourage as he made his way into the ring.
Got a good right hand to the body that time. Watch this
back here. Nothing
chopping
back
down,
here.
Though. Go.
You never know what to expect from Mayorga. He'll give you wild angles. He'll be awkward. He'll do almost anything in there. But all of that adds to his effectiveness.
I think so. Just unpredictable. You start watching for one thing, he'll get you with the other.
In the meantime, Picciarillo is doing exactly what he needs to do here in this first round.
Yeah, stay out of harm's way.
Exactly.
Occasionally, let the man know you're in there. Hit him with your jab.
That was caught in the gloves, mostly. Nice counterpunching from Picciarillo.
Sometimes a guy can look at you and not like you and decide I'm gonna disrespect you and don't understand that maybe Picciarillo's got something other than just good looks here. He may be a little power to him because he's tough.
Well, he beat Corey Spinks. You don't do that if you're not a pretty talented fighter, even if it was a controversial decision. And he's showing really excellent movement, mobility, using all 20 feet of the ring.
Yeah, making Mayorga miss.
Mayorga making him miss.
Has mostly missed this round.
Yeah. Well, so much for the 16 seconds. Now it was to his earlier prediction of two rounds. There's an old familiar name, Sambu Kalembe.
Former middleweight champion, and that's him right in front of him.
You can't be there. You're not even in the corner.
Good man for you.
Hey. No se queda con él, no se queda con el jab. Solo el jab, no, tiene que avanzar y meter su derecha.
Tiene que avanzar y meter su derecha. George Foreman technique of standing between rounds.
That's a good idea, I think. Only, but when you need your eyes worked on, you should be on the stool because you don't want to hang your head down and let the blood swell up in your face. But ordinarily, standing up is best because that's the way you train. No one uses a stool in training camp.
Also a good psychological thing. I think you used it.
Intimidating, yeah.
It,
right? Now, I was just so heavy, I knew if I sat down, I couldn't get up. Now Miyagi is starting to settle down a little bit. Get a little more focus. Wait for important shots.
Mayorga is not attacking as recklessly and as wildly as he has in some of his other fights.
No, and I think Picciarillo right now is giving him some nice angles and not standing there with him.
Mm-hmm.
should be pointed out is that it was not easy for Mayorga to make weight for this fight. So let's see what happens if Pichirillo can take him into the deep water. Well,
that's a knockdown.
It is a knockdown.
Pichirillo saying it was on the top of my head. Five, yeah, he did, but he punched you on the top of your head and you went to a knee.
Right?
He was a little off balance, but at the same time, these are points. So what do? Get up and knock him down.
Well, there's a good right hand. That rocked Pichirillo.
Yeah, that's a better punch than the knockdown
punch.
Hey, no shoulder. Watch that. But let's go.
Mayorga working the room here.
That Pichirillo is tough, though.
Mayorga, though, George, has got to be a really tough guy to fight because he's just so out of control.
And you got to have a strong jab. You got to have a strong jab. You got to make him respect you.
Step back.
But you just won't have a second to relax in there. He's right in your face.
You just hope he'll slow down. That's what you're thinking if you pitch him. Pichirillo hopes maybe he'll just slow down so I can get him.
Well, and as we said, he did have a little trouble making weight, and down goes Pichirillo. Still plenty of time left here. I don't think Pichirillo has really been hurt by either of those shots. But
no, he hasn't been hurt. You're right. Sort of catch some glancing.
Remember, Pichirillo has never been stopped in his career. And now Mayorga claiming a headbutt.
Combination for Pichirillo.
That was a hit.
Yes, it was.
Accidental.
He was right. It is Pichirillo got the worst of it.
Very likely a 10-7 round for Ricardo Mayorga. We'll take a look at the knockdowns as soon as we see the treatment done to the cut head. Michele Pichirillo. Now let's take a look at the knockdowns. You're going to see Mayorga come over the top. He's a little off balance, but he gets hit on the top of the head, goes down to one knee. Absolutely legitimate knockdown, though. Nice uppercut from Mayorga.
And that was almost as much push as it was punch.
But when the mix-up is going on, you got to call it a knockdown.
Todos los golpes van con combinaciones. Haga caso y vuelva a ir a la esquina, campeón.
Ma.
Okay.
Let's go. Seconds
out.
Okay.
But. So round number three and a big second round, needless to say, for Ricardo Mayorga. Blood continues to pour from that cut on the top of the head of Pichirillo. It's right at the hairline.
You know that blood coming down out of your face doesn't mean a whole lot because it's not in a place where you can, you know, where you can stop the fight, but you start losing energy. You don't train in camp losing blood. You fight two or three drops and you're not the same person.
And Mayorga slipped the combination in.
Mayorga seems to have found his weight here. You know, he was welterweight champion, of course, fighting at 147 when he was fighting the likes of Vernon Forrest and Corey Spinks, then went up to try middleweight with Trinidad at 160. He weighed 158 that night. That was just too much for him. I mean, it just, but if you remember, he fought at Madison Square Garden last year, Barry, at a fight we did against Eric Mitchell. He was 153 that night, but he just looked heavy and sluggish. Yeah. He seems to be carrying it better now. He's kind of gone into that weight class now much better than he was that night.
He popped Pichirillo a moment ago with another right hand.
Pichirillo is getting, occasionally he gets in a little counter right hand of his own. Not much, but it can have some effect if the fight goes on and on and on. That chop down punch. It's not a legal shot, though.
That that has never stood in the way of Ricardo Mayorga.
Mayorga got tagged with a right from Pizzarillo and took a backward step for once.
Pizzarillo is a man now, let me tell you.
Trying to get his jab back to work again.
Matter of fact, he's a little aggressive this time, Pizzarillo. Bringing the fight to Mayorga.
Looking to counter. Much better round for Pizzarillo.
Good counter at the end. Got a right hand.
This is a nice bounce back round for Pizzarillo.
That's right. He's aggressive. He's the one bringing the fight on now, Pizzarillo. Mayorga is trying to coast a little bit. Whoa, that was a good body shot. Now that can make a difference if this fight goes beyond seven rounds. That one punch.
Mayorga's been missing with a lot of right hands. The overhand rights, Pizzarillo in this round has been getting under him. You just saw him do it again.
Yeah, this is a much better round. And as we said, the farther along that Pizzarillo can take Mayorga, the bigger the question mark over the head of Mayorga.
Yeah, because he's a little winded already, Mayorga is. He's throwing, trying to hit one home run after another. They start taking the toll.
He took a funny little step there. Let's go backstage right now where JT the Brick is with Haseem Rahman. JT.
I'm with former heavyweight champion of the world, Haseem Rahman. And, Rock, you're in the best shape of your career. What do you say to your critics who say you're thinking about Vitaly Klitschko instead of your opponent, Monty Barrett?
Well, nothing could be further from the truth, but I expect to win. A win tonight over Monty Barrett, so Klitschko on the menu.
Rock, talk about the shape you're in. Not in the 250s anymore, in 230. Your arms are big. Your waist is cut down. It looks like you are so focused. What does this fight mean to you?
Oh, it means everything. This is all or nothing. My team ready. We willing. We focused. And we coming to knock Monty Barrett out.
The winner goes on to fight Vitaly Klitschko for the heavyweight championship of the world. The loser goes home. Back to you, Barry.
Thanks, JT. That is our main event. And there's the cut in the scalp of Pizzarillo. It actually looks worse there than it did during the course of the fight.
They were attending a little to the left eye. There might be a small nick around the left eye of Ricardo Mayorga. Nothing meaningful at this point. Yoel Judah, the father of Zab Judah, brought in to add some technique to Mayorga, was telling him to jab 3-4 times, then throw the right.
Yeah, but that's just tough. Mayorga's not going to do that. He tried it, but it's like, I don't really get him.
Pizzarillo is getting his confidence back here. Can't afford to be careless, of course, but.
You see, when Pizzarillo should be bringing the fight to Mayorga, now he sits back and boxes. Keep bringing it to him. Make him fight you back.
That's a
going
quick
back
jab.
Fighting him at a little more close range now than he was.
Let's go.
And countering him pretty well.
Referee Gerald Scott warning Pizzarillo about holding behind the head and hitting.
Nice combination right there from Pizzarillo.
You know, he's just.
And
missed.
There's a right hand and it drops him. So all that good work. And one right hand changes everything.
He seems to go down awfully easy when he gets hit with these rights. I mean, a lot of them have not been, you know, clean, tremendous shots to the chin.
Well, Pizzarillo, you just can't punch with a punch. You've got to box him. This guy, Mayorga, is a genuine puncher. You don't want to get in there mixing it up with him. Hit him quick and get out of range. Step to the left or to the right.
Ricardo's going right hand crazy here. He is looking for that big shot. All three knockdowns have been recorded with the right hand of Mayorga.
And I think your point is well taken, Rich. I don't believe Pizzarillo's been hurt by any of those punches.
Those are starting to hurt. Man. Rocks your neck to the side. You start having funny feelings down the back.
That was a slip on the part of Mayorga.
Fans got excited, though, because Mayorga's stumbling back.
Once again, Pizzarillo is starting to punch with a slug, with a slugger.
Yeah, exactly.
Box him. You can do better. Beat him to the shot.
Keep him up. Up, up. Well, he was having some success countering also.
Yeah, that's right. Stay out there. Wait, jab him, step back, and get him. Those body shots that Picciarillo is landing are having some effects, too.
Look at that jab, George. Picciarillo's got a terrific
jab.
He is
an excellent athlete. Feints. Long arms, elbows, covers up his body real good.
When a guy goes down that easily, George, can it just be his feet? Can it be just how he's lined up that he gets parallel to his opponent?
All of the above.
Okay. See, now there's
now
a round.
Now the stool that comes in.
Agua.
That's a round that Picciarillo won all but 3 seconds of.
Exactly. And that was Akini. He ends up losing the round probably by 2 points. There you see the right hand, right in the ear, it looked like. Side of the head. Picciarillo, though, spent the rest of the round landing good combinations, especially with the jab.
The knees are bent. I mean, it's a real, the effects of a knockdown.
Yeah, that's the side of the head. But nonetheless, they're legitimate knockdowns. There's no question. I mean, they're not controversial knockdowns at all. They're legitimate knockdowns, but not the classic knockdown that you think of. And if you take away the 20 seconds of those three knockdowns, Picciarillo and Mayorga are a dead even matchup.
Yes.
But he's well behind. He's got to be well behind, of course, on the cards at this point.
See, I made that round a 10-9 round, even though I don't think the judges will, just because I thought Picciarillo won every other part of the round.
It's possible, yeah. You and the judges have every right to do, though. But if you consider a knockdown a major moment within the context of a round or a fight, then they go with the 10-8.
Yeah. You got to get it. Got to do anything in this business. Ah! Picciarillo is starting to get in with the right hand.
Stop. No punch. Punch.
Ricardo Mayorga has enormous knuckles. I don't know if that adds to his punching power at all, but he's got these big hands and just the biggest knuckles I've ever seen on a fight.
That's why it didn't take much effort. Just swiping the guy knocks him down.
George, the comparison that we have to make, of course, is between this Mayorga, who's more measured, trying to use more technique, and the one who, you know, just recklessly and wild fought Vernon Forrest, running in, throwing everything at Forrest until Forrest finally fell. And which one do you think is the more effective guy?
Oh, both. I think now he turns it on. He's like marathon
give me a
runner
break.
Now.
Give
he
me a
comes
break.
In,
no punch.
Sprinting.
Clean.
He's trying to extend himself. He comes back sprinting again in a moment. He's understanding that he cannot connect with those wild shots, so he's throwing away a lot of energy. That's smart on his behalf.
Quiet round on both sides here in round five.
There's a slight bit of booing from the fans, which may be the first time I've ever heard booing in a Mayorga fight. That's true.
He gave us so much in the first couple of rounds, but we don't want to see any. Less action.
And again, Picciarillo is not doing, I think he's doing enough so far to win this round, but things could change in an instant.
Yeah, that jab is kind of in a subtle fashion taking over this fight. Left jab by Picciarillo starting to take over.
He's keeping Mayorga at distance this round with it. Ricardo just had a completely ineffective round chasing after Picciarillo.
That'll be interesting to see if he just kind of took that round off
George mentioned he used his stool for the first time between rounds in the last round.
Okay.
Give him 2 or 3 rounds. And again, you can't emphasize too much that he did have trouble making weight. I mean, yesterday he was in the gym trying to lose some weight before he spoke with us, which was right prior to the weigh-in.
They've been rubbing Mayorga's legs vigorously over in his corner. I've heard that's not a good idea.
Sometimes you got to keep, when those legs get old, they get old sometimes at 25, 26 years old. Archie Moore said, why are they rubbing his leg? He said, keep back the rigor mortis.
Time. Go over there. Hey. Some of that off. That's good.
Excess grease.
Time.
Good referee.
Gerald Scott. Long time.
I want to see if Mayorga picks it up here in this round after.
I think this left jab by Picciarillo can really take things over now. Pops.
There it is, yeah.
He's got his rhythm and he's got his timing just right. The head is there for him.
Right at the moment, he's out quicking Mayorga.
Out quicking, very quick. And a left hook behind the jab.
Ricardo thought this was going to be an easy fight tonight.
Give me a break.
At least that's what he said publicly.
Watch the hits.
And it's not turning out that way, even though he scored 3 knockdowns.
Shoves.
But let's go.
Picciarillo back.
You get kind of frustrated when you're throwing all that power and the guy's just jabbing whenever he wants to, hitting with the left there.
And there's another Mayorga trick here, and he's going to talk to both fighters.
Hey, none of this. We're going to keep it clean. Got it? Let's go. Bunch.
Oh! Counter left jab by Mayorga, the first one tonight.
Yeah, where's that been?
Counter with it. The way you stop a guy from hitting you with the left jab, if you kind of step over to your right a little bit with your right hand, whether you hit him or not, make him stop that. Just throw your right hand. He's moving to his left, so you just step right over there to him. That is.
Break. Give me a break.
You'll make him do something different. May not get a good shot on him, but you'll make him stop.
Picciarillo is the quicker fighter right now.
Mayorga looking for that right again.
Yeah, he is. Didn't miss by much that last time.
Uppercut.
Ricardo showing a few more things this round.
Counter left jab, uppercut.
Counter right from Picciarillo.
Picciarillo is not giving up.
Nice combination from Mayorga.
That's what he hadn't done all night, is go to the body like that.
Bottled him with the right hand that time, and Picciarillo has to get out of there. Much better round for Mayorga, and we go now into the locker room of Monte Barrett, and he's with JT the Brick. JT?
Monte, it's been about respect, no excuses. Why did you want Haseem Rahman more than any other heavyweight?
Well, Rockman is the best heavyweight out there besides Chris Burry, and I felt like it would be a more of a challenge for me to fight Rock. I can get up for that fight because him and I having some type of acquaintance, it would be a very competitive fight.
Your win against Dominic Wynn and Owen Beck, you seem to be peaking at the right time. What does that mean coming into this fight?
It means everything. I mean, with the experience, with the wins. I mean, I fought 2 undefeated fighters, and I was successful with the win, got the W, and, you know, I'm just going to bring everything that I have of the learning experience from there to bring it to this point tonight.
There is a huge payday waiting for this guy if he can beat Haseem Rahman, take on Vitali Klitschko. We're talking about big money, and he wants some of it. Back to you, Barry.
JT, thank you very much. Javante Barrett and Haseem Rahman, two guys who any other time but tonight might be found at the same dinner party.
That's right. They were together socially at the 4th of July last year. Their families got together. I don't think it'll be too social in there tonight.
No.
Mayorga again getting his legs vigorously massaged in the corner. And again, they were treating his left eye. There must be a slight nick around it. It's hard to see. It's really not bleeding, but something's going on up there.
Yeah, that left jab is not going to let it rest either. Picharillo keeps popping with that thing. You have the side of your face all swollen. One, your eyesight starts to flicker off and on and off.
Now, Ricardo Mayorga came in looking for, wanted to be sensational tonight because he wants that bout with Fernando Vargas, and thought he might really scare Fernando Vargas tonight. It has not been a scary performance thus far from Ricardo Mayorga.
No, it is not.
Vargas, you don't scare anyway.
Those would be some rather interesting press conferences before they fought.
Oh, yeah. And it would be a good fight.
Combination from Mayorga again.
Mayorga's starting to find the range with that right hand again, and he's getting a little more aggressive.
Brought it under that time. Tricked him a few times on top and then brought it under Mayorga did.
I think Ricardo's feeling it here a little bit.
Trying to get the crowd back in the fight as well.
That stick left jab that keeps sticking.
Making the slash of the throat sign.
And he tries to go come under with the next right hand.
That jab flicked out by Picharillo. Counter right hand from Picharillo. Three misses from Mayorga.
Break. No punch. No punch.
Picharillo is still in this fight. He hasn't been able to throw one hard right hand tonight himself. If he decides to dig in, he'll change things himself.
Yeah, he's pretty much staying in it with the jab.
Uh-huh.
With
the jab. That was a right hand by Picharillo. Gets one back in return by Mayorga.
A very close round, I think.
Hey, when you guys get to clean this water, man, too much.
Però gli alzano, man, mica quando vuoi scambiare, quando incrocio un
dente. Let's go.
Picharillo carrying on an entire conversation with his corner men. Only thing we heard from Ricardo was asking for water.
That's right.
Well, round number 8 of this 12-round fight.
I thought Mayorga was picking it up in that last round, getting more active, starting to feel it.
Nice uppercut. That hurt him. And now Mayorga right on, and Picharillo tries to tie him up. Best punch of the fight for Mayorga, and he thinks it's over. This is with the right hand.
It's not over, but Picharillo is in more difficult straits right now than he was after any of the three knockdowns.
And of course, all kinds of time left here, more than 2 minutes. Pichirillo back on his heels right now.
That's when a guy's real dangerous. When you're throwing him for a kill, you gotta know what you're doing. That's when you can run into one good one yourself.
Good right hand again.
Remembering. Nice and clean.
Just a little short with those two right hands. Gets right back on top of him.
Pichirillo still not all together yet.
Yeah, there's no more left jab that was really effective. There's no more. I'm not using that anymore.
Just going backward. Now he starts side to side.
What a brave man. He clears his head, gets himself in his feet in position to jab again.
And he still has the wherewithal to make Mayorga miss. I mean, still with that body movement.
I like to see a guy coming that far away from home. Still getting wobbled, stands up and fight for himself.
He's from Bari, Italy, and the only other fighter to ever come out of that part of Italy, which is on the Adriatic, who made a mark for himself in the United States, was Vito Interfermo.
Whoa, did he make it?
Another tough guy.
He made more than one mark.
Look, he gets the best right hand of the night. Good right hand.
And another one. What a nice comeback for Pichirillo.
That's what I mean, a brave man like that. That far away from home, fighting back with all his heart.
Mayorga nods his head, I'm not hurt, which generally means I'm hurt.
Membrane,
It looked like they clashed heads again.
This fight is not over by a long shot.
Pichirillo has good recuperative powers. Remember, he's never been stopped in a 47-fight career.
Good left hand for Pichirillo. And a right hand for Mayorga to end the round.
Good fight.
What a round.
Good fight.
That was a really interesting round. Mayorga staggered Pichirillo early in the round, and he really was genuinely hurt on this one. And Mayorga, very wild though, sloppy in going in after him to try to finish him off. See, that was the shot that hurt him. The opportunity was there for him, but he did not follow up well. He was wild. And then Pichirillo near the end of the round, amazingly enough, got himself back together once again and had Mayorga backing away.
No le dé chance que él tire. Usted siempre primero con dos jabs entra. Súbalo con el open. Cuando él se queda, váyase detrás. Detrás de la derecha de él se va y lo sube duro.
That's got a voice of confidence.
Suleiman, Suleiman.
Noel Judah there, the last instructions to him, telling him to jab, jab, and double and triple up on it.
Short right hand from Mayorga to start round nine.
And left jab is stinging and popping again. Pichirillo does not mind jabbing. Kept him in this fight all night.
Had an outstanding amateur career, over 100 amateur fights, member of the Olympic team.
Ever have anybody make that move in front of you, George?
No. You know, Mayorga's got to be careful. He fought a good fight in Atlantic City, in Sphinx. A lot of people thought, you know, he came back, he won the boxing match, but you just can't think that in a boxing match. You got to go to finish these fights off. Never know what's on the mind of judges. That left jab by Pichirillo really been keeping him in this fight.
And Mayorga just not doing it.
J just never think you got to fight one. You got to win it. Especially with a guy who not have a record being knocked down. Knocked out.
Backhand. Backhand him that time, which you can't
none
do.
None of this. Box, let's go.
Well, he knows a lot of tricks, Pichu.
Yeah.
Good right here, man. Just
watch
can't
the
lose
head.
Half
watch
of a round and come back and land two right hands and think you've won a round.
Mayorga, at least so far tonight, I think has been better than he was against Tito Trinidad, better than he was against Corey Spinks, but still not up to what he was when he fought Vernon Forrest.
Oh, man. You're on the scene. Nobody knew how to respect him then. He gets respect.
Men or elusive. Don't punch him on the move. Let's go.
His fights against Forrest, the first fight against Forrest, and the fight against Andrew Six Heads Lewis, he was just devastated.
Like a tornado.
All right, keep it clean. Keep it clean. Let's go.
Good right hand on the side. Slept with it, but it was good.
Punches, and the only one that managed the right hand by Pichirillo. But I still think Mayorga probably did enough. Well, earlier tonight, we saw Luis Collazo come up a winner over Miguel Angel Gonzalez. We thought about his retirement. He's with JT the Brick.
Angel Gonzalez, Miguel, you've had a warrior-like career. Are you prepared to announce your retirement tonight?
Bueno, yo creo que definitivamente quería... yo mantenerme en el boxeo pues como a nivel campeón mundial.
I wanted to stay in boxing as a world champion.
Al parecer no tuve nuevamente la oportunidad y pues sí, muy seriamente estoy pensando ya en el retiro.
Unfortunately, I didn't have that opportunity because I didn't win, but I'm thinking towards retiring.
You fought some of the greatest fighters of your era, Chavez, De La Hoya, Costazu, quickly. How does a loss like this feel knowing that you probably had a little bit more?
¿Cómo te sientes? ¿Has peleado con Chávez, De La Hoya, todos esos grandes? ¿Cómo te sientes?
Sí, pienso que pues bien, desafortunadamente últimamente pues he peleado muy esporádicamente y creo que eso me ha afectado bastante.
Said he's fought sporadically and that's what he thinks is the inactivity has hurt him a lot because he hasn't fought as much as he should have.
Definitivamente yo creo que pues en falta de ello, ¿verdad? Pues ya a lo mejor es...
I said maybe it might be time to retire.
He was one of the great Mexican boxing legends of the last 15 years. He has nothing to be ashamed about. Back to you, Barry.
All right, thanks, JT. Not a definitive retirement announcement from Miguel Angel Gonzalez, but seems to be leaning in that direction.
Well, he's had a very nice career. Miguel Angel Gonzalez, good world champion. His best days at 135, but he did give Oscar De La Hoya a heck of a go and Julio Cesar Chavez at heavier weights.
Stalking Pichirillo here. Good right hand on top of the head.
Tough for fighters to walk away, though.
Yep, it's hard to walk away from boxing. It's most different. This one you think you're wrong, they pull you back in.
George Foreman, the godfather of our broadcast crew tonight.
Miyaga stepping it up a little bit, trying those hard shots again. He's so reckless with that right hand, though. I'm surprised that Pichirillo hasn't caught him.
Came to the uppercut, lead uppercut.
Ooh.
Nice right hand.
George, do you think that the hellacious fight that he had with Tito Trinidad, and he did take a beating, over, especially in those last few rounds with Trinidad, took something out of that?
No doubt about it. Trinidad has taken a lot of people. And you're never the same. But I guess 80% of him is really a lot of boxing. He's got a lot left. Trinidad, you're right. Punch.
Stop. Watch the hands.
Pichirillo did not do a lot in this round, and Mayorga dictated the tempo.
No punch. There we go.
Mayorga's pretty elusive. He gets out of Widow's right hand.
That's typical Ricardo Mayorga. And microcosm that is what he is.
Mayorga. He's not known for his defense, but he is not an easy target.
He gives you a lot of different looks, no question about that.
You know, we heard from Miguel Angel Gonzalez as we look in here, but nearing retirement, it appears. He'll have the joy of knowing, at least if he didn't win the last fight, he won the last round he was in.
That's right.
Because two of the three judges did give him that last round, and the other scored it even. None of the judges gave that last round to Collazo.
Six okay. minutes. Minutes. Be strong. Power. Never strong. You gotta be strong this round. Strong this round. Strong. Hey, yo, but yo, stay behind the jab. Stay behind the jab. And every time, hit him in the body. Hit him in the body. In the body.
Champion.
Champion.
Champion. Second down. Second down.
It's the voice of Yoel Judah.
Father of Zab Judah, trainer of Zab Judah, has guided his career, and really Zab has matured as an athlete and as a person, turned into a fine fighter and a fine person. And there were many who questioned a few years ago whether that would happen, but he really has.
This is round 11 for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship.
When you're fighting an excellent boxer like Pichirillo, you got to break a lot of rules. If you stay in that old orthodox position, you'll never catch him. You just got to walk forward with a little dance in the step. You're not supposed to cross your legs when you go forward, but keep your hands up, get a little closer.
I detect a little more intensity on the part of Mayorga in this round. Seems to be bringing a little faster. Seems to be looking to make something happen here.
Yeah, he's picking up the pace.
Crowd booing, but as you indicated earlier, Rich, I mean, Mayorga has kind of set a tone for himself.
Yeah. He's not the one they're really booing. They're trying to tell the other guy, stand there and fight.
No punch.
And he's trying to tell them, oh, no.
Yeah, that's right. I've tried that.
Been there, done that.
Yeah. That was a left hand from Pichirillo.
But you know, what was it, three rounds ago when Pichirillo was hurt, that really seemed to take the starch out of his punches.
Yeah, trapped him in on that, over that jab. And he's just throw three jabs now, and he's thinking, I better protect myself.
Well, I don't think Fernando Vargas will fight him this way, although Fernando has incorporated more defense into his style. And I don't want to put anything past Javier Castillejo either, because he has to fight Vargas next week.
Mayorga went into this fight thinking he was going to get Pichirillo out of there, and that hasn't happened, although I doubt that will shatter his confidence.
No, because this guy's got a tough chin on him, Pichirillo. Takes a shot. It's the kind of guy that takes your confidence away, but you just got to stay on it.
Well, I think the interesting thing was the best shots that Mayorga has landed have not been the ones that have knocked down Pichirillo.
That's true. The ones that knocked him down were glazing shots. It's kind of grazed him a little bit.
End of round 11.
Mayorga just looked over at us here, and our Brian kind of shook his head.
He wants to fight. He really wants to fight.
con el paño ahí.
La pierna. La pierna.
Good, very good, very
vamos,
good.
Chan, vamos good. Al último.
Good.
Entonces, vamos al 12. Tony. Ok, Tony.
We got no leg, no leg, no leg. Stay, stay. Go, 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 go. Ahí, stay on.
Él, él con el jab. Siempre con el jab. Vamos, chaval.
Come here, come here. Bienvenido, está bienvenido. Okay. We're not the combiner skin.
Okay.
Yad, the man.
Respira,
respira, respira. Dandy,
lose my respect. That's a lot of confidence in this corner. Round 12, and Mayorga blowing kisses to the crowd.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
And gesturing over to Picciarillo in a particularly polite manner. And gesturing to him to come on, stand and fight.
Isn't that amazing?
Look at it, just come on. There's a lot of yelling going on here.
Keep it clean. Keep it clean.
Because I'm not surprised to see Mayorga act like that. I can remember my very first meeting with him, Barry and George. I sat down, I was talking to him, and I asked him if he thought his opponent, who was going to be Andrew Sixheads Lewis, was a tough guy in the ring. And he said, tough. He just laughed. He said, tough. He doesn't know the meaning of tough. The women in my country give birth to children in the street.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. That's tough. That's tough.
What are we talking about tough here? Oh, he won a fight, even at the last.
Just got to play with him for the last bit, 20 seconds.
It's been a tough fight. 12 rounds with this guy hitting you on your shoulder, Mayorga, on your back, top of your head. It's got to be rough on the body.
I don't know if it's a moral victory for Picciarillo to go.
Yeah, it is. This means a lot to him.
Yeah, I bet it does.
Well, obviously, Ricardo would like it for a guy to stand right in front of him and exchange punches. I mean, he loves a good fight. He loves to be involved in a fight.
Seconds left in this fight. And down goes Picciarillo, but they're going to say this one is a slip.
No knockdown. But
and Picciarillo has survived.
Good fight, you got.
Mayorga will be the champion. And we couldn't quite get up on that ring.
Never make it up there like that.
Hey! Tough fight for the Italian. That's his dad.
Well, he was right in there for about six rounds. And then that time he got hurt in the seventh, I think it was the seventh or eighth round there, Barry, really just seemed to sap him of his power and of his will to really pursue a victory.
I think that's right. I gave the last five rounds to Mayorga.
And Mayorga will be a wide winner, I would imagine, on the cards. There you see Zab Judah over in the corner with him. Zab and Mayorga are friends, and that's basically how It came about that Mayorga hooked up with Zab's dad, Yoel Judah.
Él no sabía de eso.
Well, he talked about getting him out of there in 16 seconds, and so I suppose that does qualify as moral victory for Pizzarillo.
Well, Mayorga's a winner. He'll go on to take on the...
He's got to wait.
Yeah, well, the winner. He'll go on to take on the winner of Vargas and Javier Castellano. That's... well, I see what you're getting at.
And all happiness in the corner of Mayorga.
Mayorga is tough, that's for certain.
And got to be tough to fight, too, because he comes from so many angles.
I mean, he started out from the first round, but he wouldn't quit. Last wouldn't round, quit. He was still trying to chase.
But he's a guy who obviously enjoys what he does, and we were talking earlier, we just thoroughly enjoyed this conversation, the conversation we had with him yesterday. One of the things that I remember him saying, in talking about Pizzarillo, and you were talking earlier, Rich, about the fact that he doesn't respect his opponents too much, he said, my gardener can beat Pizzarillo. Well, it took more than the gardener.
Ricardo tries to sell all of these fights that way, but afterwards he always has a hug for his opponent and some good words.
Yeah, you can't not like the guy. Here's Jimmy Leonard with the decision. Jimmy.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of action, we have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, John McCarthy, scores the bout 117 to 110. Judge Anik Hong Tong Kam scores the bout 117 to 108. And Oren Schellenberger scores the bout 120 to 105. All three in favor of the winner of the WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World, Ricardo El Matador Mayorga.
You're right.
A widespread winner. The judges gave Pizzarillo three rounds, and I think, Barry, you and I both gave Pizzarillo three rounds.
Right.
And he was in it till he got hurt in that seventh round, and then he just kind of went into survival mode after that.
For good reason. This guy was trying to take his head off with every shot.
So he does survive, and he gets the obligatory hug from his promoter. And there will be other days and bigger paydays and maybe tougher opponents as well.
I don't know if Vargas is in the house, but Mayorga promised us that if he won tonight, he would come back here next week and be in attendance at Vargas's fight against Castellano.
Yeah, I would love to see that fight, Vargas-Mayorga. That would be a great fight. I mean, who's going to run?
Exactly. I'm surprised that Vargas isn't in the house because Mayorga offered to buy him tickets. We come now to our main event, and to get the table set for that, once more, we go to our host position at Jim Hill. Jim?
All right, Barry, thank you very much. And when you think about Ricardo Mayorga, even though he went, he does have some explaining to do, as Barry mentioned, because he did not win in the first minute of the very first round.